Right. There is one more application or example, whatever it be. Find the value of magnetic induction B at the midpoint of two poles of a horseshoe magnet. Horseshoe magnet. This is the shape of horseshoe magnet. It is a north pole and this is the south pole. Separation between north and south poles is D. Both the poles having same strength, M and M. O is the midpoint between N and S. O is the midpoint. Let us find magnetic induction at the point O in between two poles of a horseshoe magnet. Here also we should follow the field due to isolated pole. This is taken as one isolated pole, this is taken as the another isolated pole. Due to isolated pole, you know, magnetic induction B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into B is equal mu naught by 4 pi into M by R square. Here, at O, field due to north pole will be directed away from it. This is Bn. Next one, field due to south pole directed towards the south pole, it is Bs. Both Bn and Bs are in the same direction. Bn is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into M by distance is d by 2. D by 2 whole square. Similarly, Bs is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into 4m by d square. Net magnetic induction at O is given by B dash is equal to Bn plus Bs mu naught by 4 pi into 8m by d square. It's the formula. Next one. Okay, what is the value of B magnetic induction field at any point on the axial line of a bar magnet? Axial line of a bar magnet. Let here, this is a bar magnet. It is a bar magnet. South pole and this is the north pole. O is the center of the magnet. 2L is length of the magnet. Now, the line joining the south to north and also passing through the center of the magnet is known as the magnetic axis or axial line. On this axial line, let P is any point. Distance of the point P from the center of the magnet is D. It is D. Similarly, distance of the point P from the north pole is equal to D minus L because total length of the magnet is 2L. Length from O to N is equal to L. Length from O to P is equal to D. From this point, length is equal to D minus L. Next, distance of the point P from the another south pole is equivalent to D plus L. It is D plus L. Again, at the point P, due to north pole, field at P is directed away from the north pole, it is Bn. Due to south pole, magnetic field at the point P is equal to Bs, which is directed towards the south pole. Both Bn and Bs are opposite. Net field at P is given by Bn minus Bs. Right? Due to north pole, magnetic induction at P is given by Bn is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into M by D minus L whole square. It is D minus L whole square. It is along from N to P. Along from N to P. This is the direction. Magnetic field at the same point P due to south pole is given by Bs is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into M by D plus L whole square. It is from P to S. Net magnetic induction at P is given by Bn minus Bs mu naught by 4 pi into M common this way. 1 by D minus L whole square minus of 1 by D plus L whole square. Here, LCM is D minus L whole square into D plus L whole square. A minus B into A plus B. D square minus L square whole square. And here, D plus L whole square minus of D minus L whole square. A plus B whole square minus of A minus B whole square is equal to 4AB. 4DL by D square minus L square whole square. This 4DL can be written as 2L into 2D. But you know, M into 2L is equal to capital M. What is capital M? Capital M is magnetic moment. It is nothing but small m into 2L. So it is replaced by capital M 2D by D square minus L square whole square. This is always along the axis from south to north. Or the direction of magnetic induction at any point on axial line is directed along M bar. What is M bar? Magnetic moment. Cut field at any point on the axial line is directed always along the magnetic moment. Here, suppose if it is a short bar magnet, length of the bar magnet is very less than compared with D. In this equation, L square may be neglected. D square whole square, D power 4 and this D cancel. So, BA equal to mu naught by 4 pi into 2m by d cube. From this, B and D, they are related as B proportional to 1 by d cube. So, for a short bar magnet, mu naught BA equal to mu naught by 4 pi into 2m by d cube. For a long bar magnet, BA equal to mu naught by 4 pi into 2md by d square minus L square whole square. Keeping these two formulas remain in your mind. Next one. Find the value of magnetic induction B at any point on equatorial line of a bar magnet. Equatorial line means, see clearly here, it is a bar magnet. O is the center of the magnet. A straight line passing through the center of the magnet and also perpendicular to its length is defined as the equatorial line. So this is the equatorial line. On this equatorial line, P is any point such that distance of the point P from the center of the magnet is equal to D. Here, both the poles having same strength, N, S, M and M. Now let us join the point P to N as well as P to S. At the point P, field due to north pole is, that is directed away from the north pole, it is BN. At the same point P, field due to south pole is, due to south pole the field is directed towards the south pole, it is BS. This line makes an angle theta with the length of the magnet and is also equal to theta. Now it is BN and this angle is equal to theta, it is theta, it is also theta. Bn is resolved into two components. It is Bn cos theta and this is Bn sin theta. In the same way, it is Bs. It is also, this makes an angle theta. Bs also resolved into two perpendicular components. Along this direction, it is Bs cos theta and along this is Bs sin theta. But magnitudely, Bn is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into m by d square plus L square. It is taken from N to P. D square plus L square. How? This is L. This is D. And this length is root of D square plus L square because it is a right angle triangle. So, due to isolated pole, mu naught by 4 pi into M by R square, where here R is equal to root of D square plus L square. That's why D square plus L square. Next, due to south pole, Bs is also equal to mu naught by 4 pi into m by d square plus L square. It is from P to S. Magnitudely both are same. That's why this Bn sin theta and Bs cos theta, Bs sin theta, both are equal and opposite. They are cancelled together. Net magnetic field at P will be Bn cos theta plus Bs cos theta. Bn cos theta plus Bs cos theta. Bn is also equal to Bs. So 2Bn cos theta. 2 into Bn equal to mu naught by 4 pi into m by d square plus L square into cos theta is also equal to, from the diagram, cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, L by root of d square plus L square. Next one, on solving it, B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into capital M by d square plus L square whole power 3 by 2. For a short bar magnet, L is far less than D. So, BE equal to mu naught by 4 pi into capital M by dQ. Capital M by dQ. So on equatorial line, capital M by dQ. On axial line, 2M by dQ. Right. Here there is one point. What is the direction of BE? Here, direction of BE at this point is, this is the direction, net magnetic induction. Means, magnetic moment is always taken from south to north along the axis M. At this equatorial line, it is the net magnetic induction. Means, net magnetic induction will be opposite to magnetic moment. It's very important. At any point on equatorial line, magnetic induction field is always opposite to magnetic moment. Right. Opposite to magnetic moment. So, for a given short bar magnet and at the same distance, what is the ratio B and BE? BA by BE is equal to 2 by 1.